today to recognise how influential the 70s style was. Starsky & Hutch here at the Arches in London is dripping with a 70s odour. From fashion, music, style, atmosphere, and most of all, the attitude. So if you fancy strutting your stuff in a John Travolta style to the funkiest disco beat, cool and the gang say open sesame, where KC and the Sunshine Band are waiting to receive you. Huggy Bear, yes, the original Huggy Bear, flew in from America to add a real touch of 70s revival sensation to Starsky & Hutch. While Kristos tells us why the 70s style was so influential. Huggy, there's a situation! What's the word on the street?
I want to tell you.
I'm joined by Huggy Bear, ANTONIO FARGAS. And hey baby, how you doing? And Kristos. Starsky & Hutch started as Amazing Night at Ronnie Scott's years ago, didn't it?
Yeah, we've been going for a few years now. Started at Ronnie Scott's on a Thursday night. Now expanded all over London, all over the UK. Two nights at Ronnie Scott's, Wednesday, Thursdays, Friday nights here at the Arches and at Rex in East London. Vogue on Thursdays and Saturday nights at Bagley's King's Cross.
70 style was so influential, why is that?
Well, it was just incredible. I came over a couple of years ago and I did the big breakfast and I met Kristos and Andy on the show, and they had the car and they sort of familiarized me with all the things that were going on around the Starsky and Hutch persona in the 70s and so forth.
What part of America are you from?
Los Angeles.
But
I was born and raised in New York. And then through Starsky & Hutch, I just started getting familiar with the whole world, sort of, because everybody was into the show.
How good is their representation of the 70s era with the music, the style, with everyone coming down as well, the clothes and everything?
Well, it's just nice to see that there's such a correlation between the happenings of the 70s and how it's represented here in the 90s. And I don't think you could ever really go back, but you can go forward and you can take some of the things, the music, the clothes and the style, and you can put it in today's 90s scene and it works.
When you see people at Starsky & Hutch, and obviously they all come up and get dressed up, I mean, do you look at some of them and think, nah, that wasn't, we didn't dress like that?
You know, it's very difficult to be critical when someone is paying you a compliment.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, there's not enough original clothes to go around, and now they're remaking the stuff today, you know, in the same mold as what it was then.
People can wear whatever they want to. We don't make it like a rule, you have to dress up in the 70s, because we don't really care. People are people, we accept black, white, flares, skirts, a whole lot.
Do you still get those parts now, like the pimp in the fur coat and the jacket?
Well, you know,
get typecast.
A lot of these young rappers and so forth today really are into the 70s and what we created then. And, you know, I did Snoop Doggy Dogg's video, and I even did the Backstreet Boys video, and Tony. And I'm also working on a 70s persona in terms of my own music, in terms of what I have.
You've got an album coming out, haven't you?
I've got an album coming out, and it's talking about older player talking to the young players and letting them know how to do it and how to do it right and how to be players.
So how do you do it?
How to be a player. Well, I'm writing a handbook, and you have to buy the CD to find out.
Getting back to Starsky & Hutch. Well, what's the best night at the moment that's running? Or is that too hard to say?
They're all good, but the biggest night is Friday night because of the venue. It's large and big. I mean, the Rex are trying to build that up now. That's quite a big venue. Personally, I like the Saturday night, but that's only because I don't...
Where's that, the Saturday?
That's at King's Cross. That's only because I don't have to work the next day.
Is it true that you actually own the trademark, Starsky & Hutch, now?
We own the trademark. We own the strapline, 70s jazz, funk, soul, disco.
Right.
So it's a lot about what we're trying to protect as a business. But it's, I mean, because it's such a hobby, we don't want to lose it, because it's in our blood.
The Starsky & Hutch theme tune being revamped, reconstructed, hasn't it? When's that due out?
In the next couple of months, we've got also a deal with Virgin for a 40-track album compilation of the stuff we played down the
really?
Club. And that's coming out the 4th of August.
I mean, how hard was it to get licensing for all those tracks?
Well, we're working on it now. We don't want to have a normal 70s album. We're gonna have tracks that we play down the club, some tracks that are never available before.
Cyprus, got something going on out there.
Last year in the season, we were out in Cyprus for about 3 or 4 months, and it was phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal.
What club out there?
It was a club called Babylon, but it's changed name to Starsky & Hutch now.
Really?
They've taken over the club, and
they're just taking over these guys, aren't they?
After that club this year at 4 o'clock, we've got a club on the beach called Starsky & Hutch, and people go there till about 8 o'clock in the morning.
Do you still get up there and straighten your funky stuff? Or have you hung the dancing shoes on now?
Well, my old funky stuff can still strut. Yeah. That's right. That's right.
No doubt about that.
You have to see it live and in colour if you really want to get a taste.
Chris, why do you think people like to reminisce and get dressed up?
I think people want to look cool. They want to look like as if they just stepped out of a film into the club. And I think if people just dress up normally, they feel inhibited, like they can't let their hair down so much. So they come back the next week, they're dressed up in the Al Pacino jackets, and they come there with floppy hats. Not like what I'm wearing, but they feel as though they're in the right setting with the music, and they do seem to have a better time.
Why did you come in?
Well, it's the glamour, and you don't get that in the 90s now. In the 70s, it's the glitter and the funk, and I just really like it up here. It's just really great.
So guys, what fascinated you about the whole era of the 70s? Well, he looks like John Lennon, doesn't he?
Don't tell anyone. You haven't seen me and him in the same room.
I'm sure you won't.
My main memory of the 70s,
did you keep all your old clothes? Have you got the originals?
No. I threw them away, but tonight I was thinking, I want to put some platforms on, and I threw them away, and I was thinking, I knew one day they'd come in handy.
I come to Starsky & Hutch.
Why?
Because it's 70s, and it's quite good, isn't it?
So you little hippie chick, what do you got to say for yourself?
I'm having a great time, and I love it.
Do you come here often? Oh, that sounds like a corny chat-up line, doesn't it? Well, do you?
Oh yeah, often. That's the way, I like it.
That's the way, I like it. The thing about the 70s that appeals to me is the music.
Music, is that why you come here then?
Yeah, I mean, I'll get a high off the music.
Well, you've got a lovely 70s suit on here. So where'd you get this then?
Well, I bought this in Hyper about 7 years ago, and I've kept it. It was one of the outfits I kept, and I thought one day this will come in handy, and it obviously has come down here.
So what fascinated you girls about the whole era of the 70s?
Music.
Yeah.
Music, good.
Starsky & Hutch, obviously, and clothes. So you people big fans of Starsky & Hutch?
Oh yeah!
Oh please, check the eyelashes out. But where'd you get your clothes from, guys?
Everywhere. I just found them.
Chinese dresser! Hey. Chinese platformers out there.
Those are balls that hang to the ceiling and glitter all over. Yeah.
This man's got something to say about the 70s. What is that then?
Ooh, that's nice.
Damien, just dig these clothes.
I bought it already. This is my concession to the 70s revival. Like, I'd already bought it. Without thinking of coming here. So.
It's such a cool dude. You're going to be coming back to Starsky & Hutch?
Definitely. It's been a lot of fun. It's really good fun. I mean, the old records and everything, it really takes you back. So I'm really glad I've come.
So what's the largest pair of flares that you own?
These! Woo!
How many inches?
15 inches.
So what do you think is the largest flares in inches?
About 24.
Well, if that hasn't warmed up the cockles, don't worry, because we've got loads more for you. but unfortunately you're going to have to wait until next week. You've been watching CLUBAVISION with myself, Lisa Nash, here on ITV. Coming up on next week's show, come dancing to Fever Pitch at the Imperial Gardens in London, Bump and Hustle's Red Room at The Escape in Brighton, Graham Gold's Friday Night Kiss, DJ Magazine Dance Chart, and not forgetting, loads of you lot.